According to a man by the name of Miles Taylor, a former Department of Homeland Security official, Donald Trump in April of 2019 actually promised to pardon any official at the Department of Homeland Security who did whatever they had to do, including if it was illegal, to stop immigrants from coming into the United States. According to Taylor, who released this information in an ad that aired this week during the Republican National Convention on Fox News, the president down in Tucson, Arizona, behind closed doors, there were no cameras there, gathered up all of these Homeland Security people and said, y'all have to stop people from coming across the border. This was actually in violation of the law. People are legally allowed to come in. You know, you cannot stop the asylum seekers. You have to allow a certain amount. You can't just straight up say, no, we're closing the border like Trump wanted to do. But he told them to do it, even though it was illegal. And he said, don't worry, I'm going to pardon you. Taylor's own words here. It was April of 2019. We were down at the border and the president said to the senior leadership of the Homeland Security Department behind the scenes, we should not let anyone else into the United States. And even though he had been told on repeated occasions that the way he wanted to do it was illegal, his response was to say, do it. If you get in trouble, I'll pardon you. So even when confronted by members of his own government telling him that what he wants to do is illegal, his response is essentially, I don't care. I am above the law and I will make you above the law too. And if ever there was a single statement that really encompassed this entire administration, that was it. That is what they are all about. They don't care. They know that much of what they have done is illegal, but they don't care. As long as Donald Trump has people like William Barr as his attorney general, he knows he can get away with anything. As long as we have weak leadership running the Democratic Party, Nancy Pelosi on one side and Chuck Schumer on the other, he knows he can run roughshod over these people. Oh, sure, they might make a couple of deals with him. They might try to make things harder for him. But at the end of the day, issues like this, law and order issues, like Trump likes to tweet, he can do it. And he can get away with it. But of course, you know, Pelosi and Schumer are a small part of him getting away with it. After all, they're the ones who aren't going to, you know, well, Pelosi is not going to allow impeachment of William Barr for whatever reason, I don't know. But it really is the Republicans. This is a Republican issue. This is a Republican trait. And this has become a hallmark of the Republican Party itself. So I don't want to get too bogged down in the Democratic side of this thing. They've got some blame, but not nearly as much as these Republicans have. This is how they operate now. And it's not just Donald Trump. Look at Mitch McConnell. Look at his wife, Elaine Chao, Transportation Secretary, who's, by the way, still under investigation for potential conflicts of interest of giving preferential treatment to her husband's donors back in Kentucky, sending them millions of dollars in contracts after they sent tons of cash to Mitch's campaigns. A little bit of a pay-to-play possibility happening there. And that's the kind of stuff we see all the time from the Republican Party. It's not just Trump. Sure, it's worse with Trump. Sure, there's more eyeballs on Trump, so it's more publicized. But this is happening throughout the Republican Party. Donald Trump is just very bad at it, and that's why he always gets caught. He may not always get punished, but he always gets caught.